Everyone, Dave, Display Fireworks One. We're still at PyroMaster, Cincinnati, Ohio. You know, I told Jamie, show me what else you got here. Now, he showed me an invention that he came up with that he said was ahead of its time. I'm going to let him explain it, and I'll ask some questions.
Thanks, Dave. You know, when you're in the business of trying to develop outside of the box thinking solutions, sometimes you get ahead of your time. Sometimes it's right around the corner, but never lose faith in your ideas. This idea is probably 9-10 years old now, and it's been used quite a bit, but it just never caught on. But here is its future. I said, what would it take to put a lot of mortars into a cubitainer with steel framing, fill it up with urethane foam, and it will float? And the water displacement on this is only 11 inches, so probably the other 25 inches is above any watercrest.
Yeah.
But these things float beautifully, and if you pin them together, they become such a massive weight displacement, they become a dock, and they're very stable in water that you would be surprised. But you can get 56 4-inch shells out of this. Now, even if you're not doing the water, but if you're doing a barge show, and hauling every rack in, and hauling, you know, all back and forth, all you got to do is fork these, lift these in, or sling them in, drop them, and you're ready to go. You just wire each one. Now, the ultimate future, this is my prediction, hopefully before I'm dead. We believe that the inductive coupling E-match concept, which is attached to the firework, and if every one of these mortars has the inductive coupling applied to it, all you would do is drop the shells in, cover it up, and you would do this at the factory. You would actually do this at the magazines. Cover it up, put a copper seal on it for the local authority, and just ship it to the show site. Unplug it, plug it into the control system, remove the lid, and shoot the show. So, you know, sometimes people say, what would Jesus do? I often ask the question, what would Walmart do if they owned a fireworks company?
That's a great question.
And Walmart would streamline this. They'd have this type of technology with this palletized concept in, and they would reduce labor, improve efficiency, pre-packaged, pre-this, pre-that, barcoded. And that technology exists today. It's just a question of, over time, changing the ways of the fireworks industry. I know that's what Walmart would do, some flavor of this.
There's a lot of firework companies are stuck in older ways and a little stubborn, and there's always a cost factor that they always look at all the time. But some of you younger guys out there may see the future, you know, and take some of these ideas and put them to use. This was used. You could tell it was out. You had an APA show or something.
We did the APA show and. Nashville, Tennessee, and 18 of these pods were brought in on a flat deck. They weren't loaded, but at least the pods were set down because it was sort of like the old halftime show at Super Bowl. They had to shut the street down, get the equipment up in less than 30 minutes. Then we had another couple hours to load, and as soon as that show was over, they wanted to open up that highway again.
Yeah.
So it had to be right now, and this did the job. It was very successful, and
here's one of the techniques I showed some of the people to watch my videos. Remember the hole in the mortar, and see, you know, you could tell they were in a hurry to tear it down last they used it, and they stuck it in. Jamie's predicting this is the future, that the product will come with the coil, you drop it in.
And it's always shunted. It's never unshunted.
Yeah.
So it's safer.
Yeah, and it's
the E-match is never unshunted.
And you don't have to wire anything.
No. Nope.
There'll be an electrical current that'll fire the product.
You know, there'll be an expense up front to make the conversion, but once you're there, load time is reduced. You know, even companies that have great crews, but they're mature, you could literally take those mature people and cut them in half and get two shows out of the same crew. Yeah. So you can expand your business through technology without increasing the number of... And it's also important. You want people on the show to know what they're doing. So, you know, us old guys here, we still got a purpose. And, we love the millennials. We love the Generation Xers. But we want to leave knowing that the new generation wants to do this because it's fun, because it was fun for us. The difference is, fun to us was digging sand ditches, okay? Your generation don't like digging sand ditches. You got better things to do, and I appreciate that. I appreciate that. So my goal is to make this millennial ready for the next generation to be high-tech, plug-and-play, using innovative different ways of getting there.
Yeah.
And hopefully my ideas catch.
Well, you know, there's guys slowly entering the industry that are getting creative and coming up with ideas. There's not too many good old guys like this guy out there repairing all the old equipment. You should see down in there. I mean, he's repairing all the old analog firing systems. He's like a go-to guy with the big boys in the industry that need to solve problems, amusement parks, all this sort of thing.
But we're not snobs. We work with anybody.
Yeah.
We work with anybody, all sizes of companies, training, you name it. We hope, you know, we really love providing this service for an industry which I am very fond of.
Yeah, he went out and shot shows too, right? He's been out there. He did it the old-fashioned way, drove, right?
Oh, yeah. Hand fire.
You've been all over the country.
I can remember the first E-matches in late 70s that came out. You would have thought that was at that time, that was like a smartphone, you know, E-match. It was amazing. You could hit this button.
And boom,
and 500 feet, that was just like unbelievable technology.
Oh, I can imagine, yeah. You know, a lot of it was hand-fired. Now look where we're at with computers and whatever.
Yeah, but I'm easily amused because even still, I still get excited when I see it happen 500 feet away.
Well, listen, man, thanks for inviting me down here. Being part of my website.
I'm a Cincinnati Bengals guy.
Yeah.
I love you, but I don't love the Steelers. Never will. But I want you to know that, all right?
Yeah, there's always this.
But they are a great team. They are a great team.
Yeah, well, you know, I put my friendships aside other than the Pittsburgh Steelers.
That's right? It. We're not putting any of his videos on.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
All right, everyone. I hope you enjoyed my visit here to PyroMaster in Cincinnati, Ohio. I appreciate them inviting me. If you didn't see the other videos, I'm going to have a few videos up, and it's showing you what's out there. So if you want to be part of it, you know what it's about. All right, everybody. See you.
Take care.